Good morning, everyone. We're having a little sneezing fit all of a sudden, like right before I decided to launch this thing. So we might have to remute here momentarily. Good morning, Bruce. Good morning, Evan. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Literally everyone who has popped in the chat. Cobathor, notification crew. Notification's actually working. Inkwell Monster, 16 months of subbing. Sarah had a book signing last week or 2 weeks ago. How cool is that? Like, imagine you were cool enough to have your own book signing. That would be dope. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. So, Coco Lina got a Pilot S30. I had to look that one up. It is what I thought it was, and it's really, really cool. Let me pull this up here real quick. Once I've started, I've all of a sudden feel like sneeze fest. And I'll tell you why, probably, in just a second. But I want to look at this pencil. So, I've seen these before. I like this shape, and I like these wood pencils and pens. Pilot's done a lot of like the wood treatments on some of their products in the past, and they do a really, really good job, and they're really fairly priced for what they are. This one's like $40. Yeah, this is at Useca, and they have different colors, dark brown, brown, and dark red. So like I have a dark brown Timeless, one of the pens. It's just really, really well done. And really, honestly, I think fairly priced for what it is. Tommy Song, 12 months of subbing. Thank you so much, buddy. I appreciate that. So, yeah, they do these barrel type. I just always call them barrel type because they're like, I call them like wood barrel or whatever. Even though that's probably technically incorrect, that's just what I've gotten in the habit of calling them. And they are really, really good. I fully, fully recommend these products. I almost wish they'd call them something different so we could have, like, a better name. Because, like, if you just said, like, the Pilot S30, it was like, well, you think it's probably, like, a technical pencil. And, okay, maybe it is. But it's, like, it's really cooler than the name would dictate, I think. So, anyway, very cool. I love those. So, good job. So, apparently I haven't been talking very much out loud because now I'm hearing my voice. And I'm feeling a little congested. I got two sick kids at home. COVID negative, thankfully. But both of them are homesick. Tyler yesterday and today. Elizabeth came home yesterday afternoon feeling the same way he does. Very headachy, congested, body achy. Took COVID tests. Both came back. Just Tyler took one negative. So then I didn't feel the need to test Elizabeth. But maybe I'm getting some of this crud now. It's just back to school crud. Thankfully not COVID, but that doesn't stop the close contacts emails from coming. So there you go. So if I feel a little bit like I don't physically feel bad, but now that I'm talking, my head feels like super congested. Brad, I feel your pain. My kid picked up a cold from school. My wife got it. Now I'm getting cruddy. Yeah, like I feel totally fine. Except now that I'm talking, I realize how much congestion I have in my face. So there you go. All right. Well, we're not going to talk congestion too much today. Maybe a little more. Because I have too many things to do the unboxings. Drink fluids. I was on the water kick yesterday for sure. I haven't been on the water kick yet today, but I will be after this. So I've been on the coffee and Coke Zero kick today. We started school yesterday, so all sorts of crud is incoming. Yeah. Zyrtec, I probably need to pop them. Once we get into September, my allergies hit pretty hard again. It's always a gross time for me. Hello, JD Lady. Almost ragweed season. Yeah, yeah. This actually, like what I feel right now, doesn't feel like that because I usually feel worse with the allergy stuff. But I apologize that I'll probably continue like clearing my throat and sniffling. So I didn't realize that was going to happen today. So there you go. We're all in for a special surprise today. So I'm going to go in for a special surprise for me first. We have a lot of things to unbox. Y'all saw, if you were here last week, or was it 2 weeks ago that I ordered inks? I made ink orders from Van Ness Pens, Shigur Inks, and Birmingham Pens. They're all here, all sitting nice and neatly next to me. But I have a couple other things to get to before I get into the unboxing. So here's my plan for this week. We're going to do the unboxings today, and then we're going to set aside Thursday to do the ink swabs and testing, okay? because I actually have a lot to go through that I want to get through today because I don't want to wait anymore because I want some of the stuff that's in these boxes, like what's in this one, which came from one of y'all. Do you have an overly engineered metal dip pen for testing? Andrew, I do not. I sent that to Toasty Treat, so she currently has an over-engineered dip nib for testing. Here's a question on the Yovo gold nibs worth the upgrade over the steel nib. And generally, I say no. Like, I'm happy to have, like, one of them, right? Toasty is not impressed. I don't know a lot of people that will be impressed by that, right? It is not for everyone. Like, it's one of those products. I've said it 1,000 times. It is literally a product designed for me and my particular needs. And I can't imagine that a lot of people have those exact same needs that I have for that type of product, right? Good morning, Jesse. But universally, it's not going to be a product most people like, I would think. This is the drill log that I'm talking about, obviously. And like I'm well on record saying that I love the thing and very few other people will. So Jeffrey Betts, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Welcome. Welcome. We're about to check out some pens here in just a second. But yeah, even me for the drill log, I need the longer barrel. And I only want the 0.5 tip, right? I didn't enjoy the 0.8 nearly as much as the 0.5. So it's really nailed exactly what I want. And I can't imagine, like, this is not going to be a universally beloved product. I mean, let's not even go into the cost of it, right? When do you think they'll be up for sale widely? Right now. Like, if you want, like, Kickstarter is going to be the way for now. And then probably, I would imagine, early next year. Because they're going to have to get through this Kickstarter ordering process, which they've sold a lot. So they're like, last time I checked, it's been a week or two. It was like 140K, which is a lot of pens. Do you think that it would still be the case at a lower price point? I do wonder if the Drill Log was able to sell at a quarter of the price, so there might much be higher demand. So that defeats the purpose of the engineering behind it in my head, right, Evan? Like, to me, all the pricing is in the tip design, right? The tip design and engineering and manufacturing is like a very precision, you know, device. It's almost like a watch part to me. Like, it's a very precision engineered price. So that cost is somewhat fixed, right? And then the barrels, like if you just do the standard straight aluminum barrels, those don't cost that much. I mean, I know we make products out of aluminum barrels. Like, I mean, they cost money, but not like outrageous money. I think the price is, the real cost is in that tip. So I don't see any way that these are going to be more inexpensive. What you might see is someone attempt some knockoffs, you know, something like that. Drill Log is definitely intriguing, but it's pushing close to 500 for a set I want to have. Likelihood how much I'd use it, I ended up canceling my pledge. Yeah, I mean, that's an extreme end. Like, the set I'm getting is like $210. Like, I don't know how you got to 500. That this was maybe all the pieces and parts, but like a single nib and a single barrel will cost me a little over 200, which is outrageous. Like, I'm not saying it's not, but 500 is, that's a different stratosphere. Good morning, Miss G's Crafties. Dual nib, twin barrel. Yeah, I get it. Like, I get it, Tommy. No doubt. No doubt. Yeah, that's outrageous. Like, if you think it, change my pledge to the longer barrel. I need to go in and do that. Where did you see that Canalea pulled out of the Chicago, France, San Francisco, and Chicago pin shows? Did someone say that? I didn't see that. How much is a drill log? Like, a single nib plain barrel drill log is about $220. And then you can upgrade from there. You can get a dual nib setting, like Tommy was saying, and that runs it up close to 500. Will there be drill log inspired products in 3 years after drill log flames out? I don't think drill log is going to flame out. I just think it's not a universal product, right? This isn't the Pilot G2 that we're talking about here, right? So I don't think Drill Log will flame out at all. I think there is a commitment to that product and design, and it's clearly has enough traction right now to sustain. Do I think that we'll go down in price? No. This isn't a product that's designed to be on sale or price dropped. That's the way I see it since it's been launched, right? I don't see when they introduce the product, they're actually giving us a break on the Kickstarter due to volume. I hope they do well, but I don't know if they'd be sustainable over multiple years. I mean, I'd bet on them, right? They're just not, they just may not be answering the questions that we need answered to in our community. Does that make sense? Like, I think it's fair, like, to just be like almost a strictly an art product, an art and design and drawing and engineering and technical product as opposed to a fountain pen lover product, right? I think that's a sustainable market. It's not big, but it's sustainable. That's the way I see it. Glass pens are more affordable, but they will break. The AL pens will last forever and can be heirlooms. Always beware of backing Kickstarter products that use the word heirloom in them. Brad, do you have any pens made by Mystic Pen Co? Yeah, I have one. Brad sent me one. Mythic or Mystic? I have Mythic. Is Mystic different? I love mine and don't regret a dime spent. Yeah, I don't regret mine one bit. Like I said, 0.5 dip nib is this design. This is like a me, like it's like they designed it for me. It's like they pulled that idea out of my brain. Not that I had it. It was somewhere underlying in here, way deep down. They pulled it out and said, I'm going to give you this. And I'm going to be like, yes. I also understand that this is a product for like 5% of the people that I communicate with on a daily basis. Maybe. We have working. Mythic pens. Yeah, I have one. It's really nice. I think Brad does really, really good work. I need to review it officially. I've had it for a while and I've used it. All these custom pens being made, will it be interesting to see how they are valued when they're a part of inheritances? Yeah, like, I mean, we've spoken about this, and, you know, the pen that Andrew acquired for me is kind of exempted from this category, but you do not buy pens going into them, thinking they're going to increase in value or anything like that. So, y'all please don't buy pens for investment purposes, except Andrew's. Andrew's is fine. Andrew is the new owner, as we say. First time I saw Drillog was in a video about Japan's ink testing culture. It seems kind of really targeted for people whose main thing is ink testing. Yeah, Yobo, like, they weren't going to come out of Japan in the beginning, right? That's how they launched. I still don't have info on the Drillog and how well it can stand up against harsher ink like Iron Gall. I think that's fair because I think that's one of the particular uses that you want to really, really use it for are the extreme inks, right? Like, what are dip nib pens good for? Well, ink testing, obviously. But then using the more extreme inks that you don't want to put in your fountain pen on a more regular basis. Well, how do you do that? How can you accomplish that with a dip nib? How is this going to stand up to that? Is the tip machine steel? Yeah, it's steel. Stainless. I believe stainless steel. Brooks, at a doctor's appointment, but Brad, check your phone in a second. We hear it beeping. And it's still beeping. Still beeping. Beeping. Should I look at Jonathan's texts while Jonathan's being, like, sneaky? So I hope this is something I can't share with y'all. Those are my favorite ones. Oh, it's pictures. Yeah, I'm not going to share this with y'all. I'm not going to share that with y'all. Y'all should just know that Jonathan's middle name starts with a capital A and ends in hole. So y'all should know that. It's a term of endearment. I'm not going to show y'all that. Hopefully Brooks is going to send me one of those, though. I mean, that would be the goal. He likes to be, he is that way, chat. hint, well, I mean, it kind of relates to what we've been talking about. So that's all the hint you'll ever need. You can extrapolate from there. You can probably stand up to anything that you want to use as an ink then. Yeah, I would wager it's designed particularly that way. Not a good hint. Someone's already said it. Someone already has the answer in the chat that I'm staring at right now. Someone already got the answer, so I think my hint was pretty good. I think my hint was rather exceptional. My unicorn autopsy pen came last week and now has a unicorn pen filled inside with pink glittery ink. How cool are those? Those are really, really cool. I love how that unicorn autopsy stuff came out. Aardvark hole. Yes, Namiki winner Vladdy is an aardvark hole. Hey, so how was your birthday? It was chill. So my birthday was Saturday, and everyone was working. So I my kids were playing. So like I literally did nothing on my birthday. My wife was working, and so I just like chilled and did nothing around the house and went out and saw a post on Instagram. I went out, listened to music, drank some beer, and read a book while I was sat at the pool and swam for a little bit. Saw the pick the hair down at a young age. When did the hair first stand up? Probably in high school, because I have a big cowlick, right? So it never went like totally vertical, but it's definitely some big poof. Yeah, so like I literally did nothing for my birthday, which was totally fine. Like, you know, I would have loved to. My wife and I were both kind of like frustrated, like we couldn't do something big or go somewhere. Like it's you only turn 50 once, unfortunately. I'd like to never turn any other age now. They keep getting worse. So I was like, you know, it'd be nice to go somewhere, do something, but it's just like, we're not going to do that. So, it was fine. My wife was more worried about it than I was. She's like, oh no, we're not going to do anything. I'm like, it's totally cool. We'll do it later. We'll figure it out later. So Brad, do you ever want to carry this one pen you have in your pocket and then remember it's clipless and is there an aftermarket clip that could be bought for a clipless pen? I mean, rarely, because I'm okay with clipless pens, but I have seen a lot of people modify the Kaweco clips to fit different pens that they like. So 2020 didn't exist, so you actually turned 49 this year. Exactly. Just celebrate 50 again next year. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Do over. But I was like, yeah, I was like, you know what I would like to have done? I would like me and her to like go to New Orleans for a couple nights because she's never been. And I grew up down in that area and I'd like to just go and like eat and go to bars and like for a couple days, get away. But it's like, you know what? I'm not going to do that right now. Like we can do it later. Like it's like, I'm totally fine with that. So like I said, it was really good, really chill, really nothing to it. Just another day. So yeah. We will, you know, give us another year or two and we'll celebrate my 50th when I'm 52. Brad, there's nothing like quite like a kid turning 18 to make you feel really old. Yeah, so my daughter's turned 15 and she has her learner's permit. So she's driving us around a lot. So like it's escalating quickly. It's escalating quickly. Hoping to do a New Orleans trip in the fall and bring Kirby. That would be dope. Like, I love New Orleans, but, like, you know, like, 2 days would be enough, 3 days, something like that, but, and just me and her, no kids, but, yeah, one day, not too worried about it. All right, let's get this unboxing rolling. We might have to move this man today. Check it out. Will that focus? It's probably too close to the camera. It's too close to the camera. Posture check. Inks. Brad, what pen is up for use this week? That's a great question, Bruce. So, as Bruce is alluding to, I pick one pen per week to be like my primary planner pen. My PPP. That's not personal protective gear, PPG. It's my personal planner pen. I'm hydrating. It's not a really great hydrate because it's Coke Zero. So Bruce says, what's that pen this week? So it's the Esther Brooke. Y'all don't want to know what I call this. It's the Pocket Paradise. I mean, that's the real name of it. So it is my planner pen for this week, and this is what it looks like. I gotta get this close. This nib, this is the stock extra fine nib. Look how cool this looks. This nib is really, really great. The Esterbrook, the one that others didn't want for a giveaway, it worked out perfectly because this is the one I wanted because it had an extra fine nib in it. The other ones had a medium and a broad nib in it. Yeah, so this is the Robert Oster Blue Lagoon. So I forgot to do I got the email for TSA pre-check. It's time for renewal. And I was like, I guess I should go ahead and do that. But anyway, that's my planner pen this week is this pen. So we've gone through, we've set up our days. Josh, 6 months of subbing. Thank you so much. Appreciate you. No. No, that's not what I call it. So yeah, we went ahead and did all the weekly planning stuff in here, which worked out pretty well. With this pen, and I'm really enjoying using it, and I'm actually gonna whoops. So I'll read all my notes as I fidget with buttons. What's your opinion on Staedtler pens? Which one specifically? Like the Staedtler Tri-Plus fine liners and those type of things. I think they're really, really amazing. I think once you get into like some of the ballpoints, they're average. And then their fountain pens are actually spectacular, just a little bit overpriced. So that's my general standings on Staedtler. Have you seen the new Y Studio fountain pens? Which ones before I say yes? If you want to put a link in the chat, Yobo, I will answer the question based on the link that you put in the chat. So that's me beating around the bush on your answer and making sure I don't spill beans I'm not supposed to spill beans on. So you will have to elaborate further, and then I will answer your question better. So I hear people use blotting paper. What products are out there, and what is its main advantage? The reason I use blotting paper is for hand oils and like moisture, right? I don't use it to write on my page, and then close the book to dry the ink. I use it when I write to rest my hand on, because with fountain pen nibs and inks, especially like the oils on the page, make a difference on how the ink performs and the nib performs on the page. So that's how I use blotter paper, as opposed to using it to write a bunch and then put it here and then close the book. So you can use a regular sheet of paper for that too. You don't need blotter paper for that. All right. Gotta think. Can you say oils again? Say oils. Oil. Am I saying it wrong? Earl. That's how my grandmother used to say it, Earl. And her husband's name was Earl, so it was hard to tell the difference between... And Earl worked for an Earl company, so it was a hot mess at the house. It's no wonder she'd like to drink old fashions. Earl, get the Earl from the Earl feel. All right, so we got the iris. Fresh from a particular viewer of this chat. Sound like alls oil? No, I say oil reasonably normally. I probably get loose on it sometimes, just from the southern coming out, but I generally say oil pretty normal. My cousins called me Earl because they couldn't pronounce Ariel, so now my family just calls me Earl. Oh no. Well, yeah, I grew up in where oil was Earl, and yeah, that's the South for you. So we got the Rainbow Vac bought secondhand from one of you lovely, awesomes peoples. So yeah, I'll be anxious to get this inked up, test it out. What nib did I get? Did I get extra fine? Fine. Perfect. Actually, fine's probably good in a vac. In a larger pen, I probably like having wider nibs. Like, we've talked about that before. So, in a bigger, heftier pen, it's harder for me to use, like, the ultra-fine nibs that I like. So, this should be a good match for me. It feels good. Edges are sharp up here, but they're so high. I think it's going to be good. I'm just interested to kind of give it a spin compared to the previous Twisby's, the Twisby Vax. Yeah, it is a great size, great feel. So it's a little bit out of my wheelhouse for Twisby's, to be perfectly honest. You know, it's just because of the size and the shape and a little bit of the aesthetic, but the aesthetic is the best on this one. The aesthetic on this one's killer. I was watching a TikTok in Alabama where they're all pronouncing oil and it was just, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We had some folks over recently. We had a shrimp boil, and we had a discussion to say boil. I never say bowl. Shrimp. We don't have a shrimp bowl. It's boil. So, yeah. I just bought a huge pen and immediately pulled the stock medium nib and put in something rather broad. Shocking. Yeah, that was 100% the move, Andrew. We talked about that. It's a bit big for me, but balance. My wife just got an Iris. The EF nib is fantastic and oddly finer than the EF and the Rose Gold Eco. That is interesting. They are a little bit different size nibs, so I don't know what if the manufacturing's a little bit off in those line width variations. Now that you say that, I tend to like the bigger, like the 580 sized EFs over the Eco EFs. Now that you say that, I'd have to think about that a little bit more because the Eco nibs are shaped a little bit differently. And I wonder if it's just like a little design, almost feature. So, yeah, well, I love the 700R, but the criticisms about the mismatched finishes are valid. The Iris does look a little like they torch the whole thing to distract you from the whole mismatch. I think that's exactly probably how I'm going to see it, Evan, right? I thought the previous design was just a little bit problematic from making me think about something that I don't want to think about, right? So we're going to keep this out because this is going to get inked soon. We got to dry it out. So this is one of the features of a vac, so it was cleaned appropriately. But what you have to do, at least what I do with my vacs, like with my 823, is when I clean it, I will just leave it uncapped for like a day or two. So, and let it air dry out and get this, you know, get the piston back, you know, from sealing off, let it air out, that kind of stuff. So, what ink are you going to use? That's a good question. Luckily, I have about 10, 12 bottles of inks we're about to unbox here. Is that the cheapest vac fill? No. They have the mini vac, which is like $20 cheaper. It's obviously a smaller pen. Schmevelin, 30 months of subbing. That's nuts. Thank you so much. You are awesome. Is it a good idea to get one Yovo gold nib to swap between pens? That's what I do. I do that for my Yovo nibs. I have more than one, but I have like two or three, and I have like, you know, 20 plus Yovo pen fittings that I can use them in. I have one Bot gold nib and I have one Kaweco gold nib. And when I choose to use them, it's just the nib I move around. I don't need to buy more Yovo gold nibs. Like, I've got what I want. I have them set up how I want, you know, with different nib grinds. And then I put them in the pen that I want when I use it. Yeah. I think that's the play. You don't have to get a gold nib every time you buy a pen. What do you mean by mismatch? So it's harder to tell on this pen, but in previous versions, what they would do, so like the clip here has a matte finish, while these are the trim has polished finishes, and while it works on this one because of the way it's torched and finished and anodized, like it all kind of like has the same aesthetic. But what would happen with the previous versions, the clip would look very strange in relation to the rest of the hardware on the pen, and it just really stood out, and I thought it was a little bit strange. So like, it's not bad. It's just like, why? I've been asking why a lot. That's kind of my thing. So, the big question is, the 700 vac better than the 823? I mean, zero chance. But that's an unfair comparison. That doesn't mean that the 700R is not a top tier pen. It's just not going to be the 823, because almost no pen is going to be the 823. You got an awesome clip color. Is there some variance in the clip color? Like, you can get a different shade or a different type of finish. So that's what we mean by mismatch. And you'll have to, you can see it better in some of the older models with the solid colors. The 823 is also $200 more. Yeah, and it also has a gold nib. And I mean, there's a lot of reasons why it's more expensive. It's just, it's flat out. If you're asking me which is the better pen, I'm never going to say the 700R. It's just not. But that doesn't have anything to do with, is this a good pen or not, right? That's how you have to think about it. Your wife's is pink and purple. Interesting. So yeah, this one's like green and purple. Interesting. I'll have to check out some pictures now. But yeah, we'll link this one up. I want to clean it out a little bit. I want to clean it out again. I always do that with secondhand pens. Go ahead and clean them out an extra time, as opposed to like new pens. I might just go right out of the box into the cleaning. So love the matte clip. Yeah, it's really, really crazy. Iodized. I use the wrong terminology a lot. Has anyone seen what the shipping cost is in the Drill Out Kickstarter? I haven't, but I don't know that I've looked. Yobo, still waiting on that Y Studio link so I can answer your question or not answer your question. I know. I get all kinds of terminology wrong. I get emails when I get them of people correcting me, or y'all correct me here. It's like just one of those things that sometimes I just get talking and lose track and lose sight of things that are reasonably close but not technically accurate. And like, it's cool. Like, I'm really good with being corrected. Like, I don't mind that at all. I would rather get it right because I get lost sometimes. All right, Yobo came with the link. Let's see. Let's see if I know about this pen already. Yes, I do know about this pen already. I will be getting some of these as soon as our friends at Kinder Industries have them. Let's see if I can embiggen this. I was hoping this would be it. It's like I'm not allowed to talk about it, but if it's public, then whoops, what did I hit? Then we can talk about it. So what Y Studio is doing is they have that. So they did the lacquering on their rollerball pens before, right? So this is like the brassing style, right? The black one here, and then they've had the brass and copper ones before. And then they did the lacquered versions of the rollerball, and now they're bringing the lacquered versions to the fountain pen, but they're making the fountain pen the desk pen size, right? So the pen that I love that y'all hear me rave about is the Y Studio Brassing Fountain Pen. It's a number 5 nib, narrower pen, and then the desk pen is, I think, a number 6 nib, larger pen, and this is a larger pen barrel, larger nib with a lacquered finished. So they've kind of upgraded it. They've taken, I'm just seeing if there's anything different they say in here. It doesn't look like it. So they basically taken the desk pen feel and turned it into like a standalone capped lacquered finish fountain pens. These are going to be awesome. Like, y'all know me. The shadow and the red one looked like it had a nib sticking out. That would be crazy. So y'all know I'm going to love these. I don't know the price yet. Y'all want to guess prices? I don't know the answer, so we can guess. Nerdhala, thanks for the follow. Hope you enjoy pens. That's what we're talking about today. Y'all want to guess prices? Let me think about it. All right. It's either going to... I think they're going to be either 275 or 325. What do you think? 112. You're drunk. Yeah. I'm going 270. It's either 275 or 325. 279? Yeah. It won't be 200, I don't think, because the brassing is 180 or 189. How much is the desk? Yeah, 275-ish. If they go over like 325, we're probably going to have a different conversation about it. But we'll see. Yeah, just based on their current product lineup, I think that's probably the range for these. We'll see. It's up for pre-order. Oh, so what's the price? Do we know? Does it have a gold nib? It does not. These are steel, gold-plated steel nibs. 160. Is that US dollars? If that's the price, I'm shocked. That's cheaper than the... If that's the price, that's crazy. Good. That's awesome. I don't love their new logo. I like the old logo better, but that's cool. You almost won. Yeah. Price is right rules. I wouldn't have guessed this in a million. I wouldn't have guessed that this would be less expensive than the pen that they already sell that's smaller. But hey, I'll take it. And these pictures don't like to individually embiggen. You can also get it engraved. That's probably just from Y Studio. So cool. That price is nuts. It is a brass base. It specifically says it's a brass base right here, cut from solid brass. So I don't know. To me, it sounds like it's the same pen. I mean, the same base pen. Right, Paper Cat Lady? I mean, it says it. Cut from solid brass, the pen's hexagonal body follows the brand's most popular design, pure and simple, with a thicker pen body and just the right balance of weight and solidity. Solidity. Does the original Y Studio fountain pen come in aluminum? No. The one that I have, the standard brassing, is not too heavy. Yeah, I'm surprised. Like, hey, sweet. I was not prepared for that. So, I'm going to cause some problems. Let me see if I can cause a problem real quick while we're doing this. And then we'll get to some other unboxings. All right, I've sent a text. Let's see if I can start trouble. 46G is a weighty pen. Yeah, what's the, do they have the, where is the standard? So this is the desk pen. This is the one I thought it was going to be based off of. This is the one I have, the portable. And I was basing it off this price. This is a smaller pen than the last one. They don't have the weight on this one. That's what I was looking for, to see if they had the weight on this one. It's definitely nowhere near that weight. And then this was the desk one that I thought they were going to be building it off of. Is it smaller than the brassing? I don't see how. Let's see. I was checking for weight here. All right, so the brassing is 138 millimeters long. Is that how I read that? It's the same exact length. Exact same length, just wider. So yeah, everything about it says this is a bigger pen for a lesser price. It's kind of, I mean, that's awesome. Y'all know how much I love this pen. And now you're telling me I can get it in these colors and cheaper? We'll see how the weight is. Like Toasty Treat saying, that's a pretty heavy pen. And you know, my thoughts on the large, wide, heavy pens. All right. Very cool. Very cool. So are you getting the Sailor 110th anniversary pen? I am not. It looks amazing though. I have, so after the pen sale completed, I've been pretty content. I haven't even inked up any new pens since the pen sale completed. That's going to change today because I have some pens I need to ink up, but I was waiting for these new inks to come in. So let's continue the unboxings, and see what we got going on here. All right, we're going to leave the vac out. It's going to get inked today or tomorrow whenever I get it cleaned up again. Let me open this one from Jet Pens. Because I can't remember what's in it. I think it was just, this was just like some extra stuff. So I have probably in the next couple of weeks, I think I said this last week, I'm starting to get some of the planner stuff from Jet Pens. So we're going to be talking about that a lot over the next couple of weeks. I just can't remember what's in this. I think this is some stuff I just picked up from the... All right, let's go in. I guess we'll go in blind. Smand! Oh, this was the swipe I gave away. These are the swipes I gave away last week. So what did I give away? I gave away the black fine. The Twisby's packaging is getting like really refined and nice. I like the smaller, cleaner packaging. Hey, Molly, how are you? Are these taped shut? Yeah, this is the one I gave away last week. Speaking of giveaways, I'm giving away a Faber-Castell Grip fountain pen today. So go check out penaddict.com for that giveaway. I'll be giving stuff away here on this stream too at some point in time. So I'm giving away the black fine one that was on. Oh, look, I keep talking about this stuff. I can see it. Can you see it now? So I gave away the fine black one. Right, so I'm not going to open this up because they do the little Twisby stickers on here that you can't see. I like their new little concise packaging. I'm down with that. All right, so this one is going to be mine for testing. So Kimberly reviewed hers last week on the blog on Friday. I think she felt pretty positively about the whole thing. Speaking of planners, full Hobonichi lineup reveal tomorrow. Time to plan ahead. Yeah, so I got an early look at that, and I'm not allowed to talk about it. Sorry. It was cool, though. Did you get a pack of the cartridges? I did. So I got this for me. I got the blue extra fine for me to review. I still don't love the clip, but I'll get over it if the pen is good. Right, like I'll get over the clip. Hey, Queen of Washi. So yeah, feels good. Rounded grip section. That'll take some getting used to, which is fine. I mean, most of my pens have that, but I'm used to grabbing a Twisby and being fixed in there a little bit. Does anyone love the clip? I think people don't hate the clip, but I don't know if anyone loves the clip. It's a yeah. It's a thing. Yeah, the clip is very 90s rotring, which at the time was not a great compliment. It's got some rotring core vibes going on in person. You know, the extreme design of the pen. All right, so it comes with this converter. I'm anxious to see. Like Kimberly liked it. Like Kimberly said, hey, it worked good. I'm a little bit more anxious. I don't love the seal on here. It doesn't take a lot. Thinking of it as my Iopenna clip, it's a roll stop, not a functional clip. Yeah, I get that. And then what does it ship with here? Apparently, it ships with different parts in different parts of the world. Like U.S., like there's a U.S. kit and then there's a non-U.S. kit. Is that correct? Is my correct understanding? So this is a standard cartridge, standard converter, standard piston converter, large capacity, right? This is definitely some large capacity situation going on here. Wow, the tiniest agitator ever. Can y'all even see this guy? I thought it was just like a water droplet in there, but it's like the teeniest, tiniest agitator. Like, almost one of, it's like a little marble game that you play trying to get it, like, lodged in into the bottom. That is tiny. All right, that is a big converter. It definitely has more weight to it than this one. And then here's the big old cartridge. These are some big honking cartridges. It's like one bead from a hacky sack. That's exactly right. I want to see something here. Y'all know how the Pilot Con 40 or 50 converters versus the Pilot Con 70 converters give your pen a completely different feel. These converters are different weight. I saw somebody on Facebook saying the regular standard international cartridges don't actually fit snug when inserted. If that's true, or did this person have weird cartridges? Kimberly said the same thing. So Kimberly, said the exact same thing, that she felt her international fittings were loose. Like it was almost kind of wiggly in there. But like just a second ago, I don't know if you saw me, like I'm not getting like look how easy that is for me to like post and unpost on there. Normally it's a little more of a little bit more force to get it removed. All right, we're set on grams, so that converter is 3.1. That converter is 4.9. So yeah, like you can feel it. This will change the weight distribution in your pen. I think that's what the little spring is for. Makes sense. But hear me out. What if you didn't have to design it to use a spring? Hear me out. What if, chat? What if you didn't have to auto-correct your own problems? So, anyway. Anywho, why would you want to do that? I don't know why you would want... I don't know why you'd want these things to fit in here tightly, chat. I just don't know. I have some pin dropping to do. All right? Y'all back off. I have some pin dropping to take care of here. Back off, chat. I mean, Mafia Geek, I don't know what to tell you. Some of us have it, some of us don't. Ooh, boy. Okay. So, in the end, what I'll really care about is, hey, does this feel good when I'm writing with it, and does the like the cartridge stuff, like does the piston converter and the cartridges work? I assume the answer is going to be yes, but then we're going to have a problem of it not having a universal fitting, and then that's going to be a little bit of a disappointment. It looks like the Eco Nib. I'm assuming it is. So it looks shaped like it, a little bit narrower shape. New nib design, though. It's got some swirls on there that they don't, that they haven't had in the past, right? Or do the Ecos have the swirls and I'm just drunk at 10 o'clock in the morning? So, yeah, I think in the end, we're going to have to ask, okay, cool pen. Can I use it with other stuff? And I guess that's what this converter's for. And I think, I don't know. Will a new fountain pen user be comfortable buying this pen? Right? Like, you and I can mostly, we can figure this stuff out together, right? We'll say, hey, I got a problem. We'll fix it. We'll find it. What is a new fountain pen user going to say? Are they going to, it can be eyedroppered, yes. Yari Zakura, thank you for the follow. Appreciate you. Talking about pens this morning. I got this thing stuck. Yeah, Kimberly's test, she eyedroppered it, and it looked like it would hold fine, and she didn't even seal it up with silicone grease. All right, so this was the JetPens order. So there's the little your little medicine box of blue cartridges. I just figured I'd test them out, try them out, and see. So, like, I think, like, what I would use it for is the converter with non-Twisby cartridges and inks and stuff. Oh, my goodness. Thank you, but I'm glad this popped up in my feed. My ruling pen just arrived today, and I'm excited to try it out. Ooh, you are in the right place. I don't have a ruling pen or a, or my folded nib pens in the other room. But come back, I mean, stay here today. But we're about to open up a bunch of ink. And then on Thursday, I'm going to do a bunch of ink sampling and swatching. So that'll be good for your ruling pen usage. Okay, how do we want to open these without shooting them across the room or breaking my nails? There we go. So your little Altoids tin of cartridges. Isn't that cute? Oh, that's so cute. Like, this feels like aggressively wasteful. I mean, I'm not, like, I understand that I don't have a low carbon footprint. These seem aggressively plasticed. Like, they're just big and bulky and they come in the plastic container. Maybe it's an eco-friendly plastic container. I don't know. It seems like a lot to me. I don't know why I'm getting a giggle out of this. It is aggressive. It is aggressive. Like, it's cool. Like, it's cool, but I don't know what else to say. There's so much ink in them. Yeah. So it's like, am I just going to use my swipe with these cartridges? Maybe. Maybe we just set it up to be that pen, but it feels like a lot. How much were these? It bothers me that they aren't filled equally. Damn it, Thor. Now I need to go look at them. It's so nerdy. It's really great, right? All right. Ooh, that one's really not. I don't know. They're not bad. The bubbles are just in different locations. So, there you go. Is Mont Blanc Psychedelic Purple a bad ink? No, I don't think so. $610 for the pack? Yeah, I need to look at the thing in here. I mean, that's a great price, honestly. It seems like a great price. Morning, Aurelius. Now I want a silver case like that? Yeah, like, let's... Maybe me and Brian should make an aluminum cartridge case. Brian, are you listening? Take notes. Me and Brian will make an aluminum... God, this is hard to open. An aluminum magnet cartridge case. Son of a biscuit. So this just has, like, little ridges in here. They don't snap, right? So I think once you use some, you might get some movement in here. I don't know. I don't know if the ridges are deep enough. But Brian, if you're paying attention, aluminum cigarette case for ink cartridges. Bam. There you go. Spoke cartridge case is an accessory for the Axel S. That's not a bad idea. All right, they don't put the prices on here. So Toast, you saying what, $610? All right, here we go. The hell are you talking about, Dave? People were complaining about Psychedelic Purple because they didn't like having their third eye squeegeed clean. I don't know what that means. Franklin Christoph ships cartridges in a metal case? Yeah, we should do that. All right. Let's get some lols. I heard you're going to Japan for vacation. Yeah, I'm so excited to visit Dotonbori. Can you pick up something for me while you're there? Sure, what do you need? How big is your suitcase? I need 50 high-tech C-pens, 50 Signo pens, 12 Apica notebooks. Oh. Nice. Bill Hicks joke about psychedelics, gotcha. You just buy a suitcase when you're in Japan? I think that's the play, right? Brad, if you make an aluminum case for standard international ink cartridges, I would totally buy that for my desk. Please make it. Yeah, I was only half joking. Like, I wasn't even really joking. The Edelstein are metal cases, and the J. Harbon have those round cases. Yeah, those are cool. You get all that stuff from Jet Pens? That is true. Yeah, I do like those Edelstein tins. Those are cool, but those are expensive. That's an expensive ink cartridge. I mean, I use them, but they're really, really nice. It's Novin. Thank you for the follow. Thanks for coming to hang out. Ooh, sorry. We're going to get some unboxing ASMR here. We are very packaged. Oh, I know what we got, chat. I showed y'all this last week. I forgot about this. Here. Y'all be thinking about this while I unbox the rest of my loot. Y'all be thinking about this. Brad, have you ever looked into vintage fountain pens? I have a few. I just prefer modern. I never really latched onto it. Two vintage pens is a thing. I like the few vintage pens that I have, and like I'm good with that. All right, so apparently I found the need to order an extra converter. I'm not sure why. Maybe I didn't know it came with like 50 converters, and I'm only gonna use ink cartridges anyway, so there you go, extra converter. All right, smack it, oh my God. What are y'all doing to me? I just ordered a Kuratoga because of your review. Nice. Kuratoga is awesome. So maybe you need to quadruple the price of your Kuratoga and get a smart jacket for it. I'm not gonna open this yet because I want to take some pictures, and I don't have a stock Kurutoga in here to go ahead and build this out. But we will build this out one day on stream and see why. And then I'll also bring in the actual Unis grip that I have that I actually think is super cool and functional. This one that's an entire pencil wrap. I'm a little bit curious. Again, like, not that it's not cool and awesome, but I'm wondering why. But maybe if it fits it that well, it doesn't feel overly heavy, right? It feels just like a nice lightweight aluminum. Maybe it makes it cool. I don't know. We'll see. But we will build this on chat one day. I just have to go pull out one of the, it only fits the stock Kurutoga, like the basic plastic barrel Kurutoga. Studio Ghibli editions of the Kurutoger are the best. They really are good. I don't hate the smart jacket. It gives a better grip without adding ton of weight. I'm more worried about the diameter head full of ideas. And I just fumbled picking up my swipe so it fell. Reason for the spring. Get composted. I don't know what to say. My apologies. Do they have smackets in different colors? They do not. Excuse me. I think they have silver. I think they just have black and silver. They don't have like bright anodized colors. Then we're talking. But I think this was like $20. And it only fits like the $5 pencil. The diameter is why I got it. Good for arthritis days. I gotcha. Like, that's totally fair. But like, one of the things that I always talk about for my usage is the, like we were just talking about earlier, the wider the diameter gets, the wider the nib I need. In like using a 0.5 pencil, having a wider diameter, I tend to lose that control. Right? So. So yeah, we'll see. Now that I feel it, I think we might be okay. But we'll see. I just don't know. Just buy like a Kurutoga Roulette or one of the fancy models. I don't know. This is interesting. I just saw the patterns of this and ordered it, and it was Kakuyo. So it's washi tape, but it's on these little thread bobbins. I'll open that up 1 second. So, can we rewind? Rewind real quick. All right, y'all ready for this? Oh yeah, I have to click over here to move it. Y'all ready for this? Our U.S. street price will be $140. Straight from the horse's mouth. Ish. They might have their math wrong. Maybe 150. Something like that. So, less than that. Crazy. Interesting. Oops, wrong screen. All right, let's do bobbin washi tape. So I thought these were cool little patterns. These are like little baby size washi tapes. They'll go in the penguin's bottom. So they're super cute. I like the patterns. I like the little setup. And then you can keep them stacked together. Oh, that's pretty cool. So you can stack them all together when you're not using them. That's actually kind of cool. I'm down with this. I wasn't sure at first, but yeah. I bought them for the patterns. I like the patterns on the tape. But you can stick them all together and just have like a tower of tape. They look like bobbins. That's why they're actually called bobbin masking tapes. Bobbins. Ebrithil, thank you for the follow. Sounds like you're also down with the sickness. Yeah, did you hear me at the beginning? It's like I can feel it like in my talking and in my face. It's not awesome. So yeah, these are pretty cool. Yeah. Yeah, the more I talk, the worse it gets. Oh, making a disturb joke. Sounds like a you problem. So yeah, pretty cool. I like them. All right, these are gonna go straight into the penguin. We didn't even have to take them apart to go into the penguin chat. It was aggressively penguined. No, man. I didn't have to take it to dinner and nothing. I've awakened the beast. Now he's sending me all kinds of stuff. Okay, this is funny. Held a message for sex-based terms. The term is NSFW. Oh, wait, there's more? Brooks just posted a custom handle for Drillog Nibs. Damn it. Yeah, he texted it to me. I wouldn't tell chat what it was. Oh, my God. I didn't see this. Why? Oh, wow. Why didn't I see this when I ordered? Oh, here, let me show y'all. Sorry. So, yeah. That's what Brooks was texting me, so... Very cool. So there you go. Perfect. Yeah, like Brooke says, I just backed the Kickstarter for Just the Nibs now that I know that this works. It's the move. How much are Just the Nibs? I think 140. Is that right? Around 140? They're still very expensive. How much is a Brooks handle? You'll have to ask Brooks. He like literally just made this and posted it. It may not even be for sale. I'm sure he would commission them, though. All right, these bobbin accessories are sick. Why did I not get any of these? That's what I need. Where's the sewing machine? Oh, my God. It's got a handle. Check this out. You can refill the bobbin, son of a gun. That's awesome. I've never seen this before. Yeah, that's cool. I'll have to get that the next time. I'm going to pretend I'm not seeing this. Like, I will literally never do this, right? I'm just going to have to go. I'll just buy more washi tapes, but I'm still going to order it. Kikuyo Bobbin Washi Tape Mini Roll Maker. But it's basically like rethreading your bobbins on the sewing machine. That's crazy. All right. This is going to be an epic stream today, apparently. All right, since we're, like, we have no end in sight for stream, and I have no stop time today since everyone is here already. My kids are homesick, and my wife's off work. Let's do a giveaway now. I'm going to go stand up for a second, grab a drink while the giveaway is running. And for the giveaway, this is what we'll do. Hi. Both kids are sick, yeah. Fortunately, not COVID, but it's not great either. It's just all the school crud. You can hear me. I'm getting in. I'm about to cough as I'm talking to y'all. The more I talk, the drier my throat gets. Hey, Pretzel Witch. Yeah, thank goodness it's not COVID. This is why my Monday sucked, because I was running around getting COVID tests and sticking swabs up my kids' noses and crap like that. Look, thankfully, it all came back negative, but like yesterday was a nightmare of a day, but today is here. All right, this is what we're gonna give away. So Yamamoto Paper has done the, I'm gonna stop here. Schmevelin, isn't it funny that we have to say that now every time? I've been sick, not COVID, for the last 5 days. That's like both my kids are at home, not COVID. Both my kids are sick, not COVID. Yeah, I feel like we have to say that. We have to like totally caveat that every time we say how if we're sick or not. But yes, I hope you feel better. So the paper tastings, yes, you can eat these. Yamamoto Paper does a great job. And the reason I ordered this set, because this is the traditional like planner paper that you get in different Japanese planners, right? So how many sheets of each? So this is the Jibun Techo paper. It is the Corona. So the Kokuyo thin paper, the Corona paper, and the Tomoe River paper. So all in one little set. How many pages of each? It doesn't say. Anyway, this is what you get. So let's give this away. And I'm going to go grab something to drink and blow my nose. It's just a sneeze, not COVID, right? My kid got contact tracing. We get those emails like multiple times a week. Got one yesterday for my daughter. Contact tracing. Contact tracing. Contact tracing. Corona paper. Oh, no. I'm sending all the virus. I'm glad I don't feel terrible, but like this talking is catching up to me. But we got a lot of work to do, chat. We got a lot of inks to get into here. We got three boxes of inks to do next. So let's do this. If I had the Jeopardy theme, I'd play it. All right, it's open to giveaway. Exclamation point raffle. I'll leave all this mess on the camera so you don't have too much of a chair stream. And I'll be right back. Bringing a friend back with me, chat. Come here. Come here. Oh, hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. Power belly, 28 months of subbing. Let's go. Let's go. Toby says hi. What's going on, buddy? Toby is taking care of all the sick kids in the house, huh? But he came running in here after me when I came back. Toby didn't want me to leave, huh? Did you, bud? I know. That's the good stuff, isn't it? That's the good stuff, isn't it? Toby has germs. You have germs. You have germs. All right. You ready? There he goes. All right. He was very concerned about all the sick humans. Yeah. Shmevelin with the gifted sub. Thank you so much. Let's go. Let's go. All right. Let's see who won a giveaway. Gamma Gamma. What's up, Gamma Gamma? Ooh, we're going to use some new bobbin tape. Gamma Gamma, have you won? We're going to give you a bobbin tape. Let's see. Hype, hype, hype. Rigged. I gotta get that rigged emote. Ah, I need to email Angela. That's what I need to do. Alright, we'll write it in this pen. Alright, Gamma Gamma, you gotta email me. You know how. You know the rules. See if this pen's writing this morning. I do have some drying out sometimes with this, but nope, all good. Oh yeah, that's a little dry. Could be the ink too. Hey Bruce, we don't beg for gift subs. We don't ask for gift subs. It's not the rules. No rules, no asking for gift subs. We just let it roll. And it worked. But yes, as a rule, y'all should know. Y'all know. Don't ask for gift subs. We have a really nice, gracious community here that is wonderful. So thank you. All right, Gamma Gamma. Let's get into some inks. All right, let's start with Shigure inks. It's the smallest box. Let me make some room here. Spoilers, yeah, no, I haven't watched the last episode of Ted Lasso, so definitely no spoilers. Let's just make Ted Lasso off limits. Hey, there's my address right in front of everybody. Cool. That worked out. What was I gonna say? Oh, Ted Lasso. Yeah, we'll hold the Ted Lasso talk till well after the whole season goes. But I haven't watched the latest episode yet. But we'll be caught up soon. Probably tonight. Probably watch it and see. And it's funny. I will say that everyone so far is saying like every episode's been the best episode ever, which is very cool to see. All right, I just got to get some room here, figure out what I'm doing. Scrub that from the VOD. I'm not overly concerned about it. I think people have my address. I'm not hard to locate. But I'd rather just not throw it out there on purpose. Not a big deal. All right, do we have room yet? I think we do. All right, let's see what we got here from Shigure. Ted Lasso is what my soul needs, that is a fact. Toasty, I have a highly specific question from you if I made your ears perk up by calling you out by name. I think you might have the same or a similar desk mat to me. Have you ever tried to clean it with anything? because I get these dirty boxes and stuff on here. And, you know, then I end up eventually writing on here. So, all right, see you, Aurelius. So, I wonder if there's a, like, could I just Windex this? Probably could. All right, y'all settle down. Roy's my favorite. I don't want to hear it. He's here. He's there. Sorry, mods. All right, let's see what we got. We got some Kalas, some Pannonias. And then we got this neon set of stuff. So we'll go through these in just a sec here. See what we got. Love that Pannonia logo. Yeah, I've been very happy with their inks. That Penzo with the gifted sub. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Check that out. The Venta neons. I was watching the practice clip the other day. That practice clip is great. All right, let's see what we got here. Oh, let me get this off here. All right, so this is the Venta Inks Neon Collection. I bought this to do a giveaway, not today, chat. Simmer down. We're gonna give this away on the blog eventually. So Venta did a neon set. Penzo with another gifted sub. You are awesome. Penzo, thank you so much. I really, really appreciate you doing that. That's amazing. Very, very cool. Artisan and handmade, 15 milliliter bottles times 3, water-based, pen ink for fountain pen. All right, so Poppy, Astro, and Tagpuan, if I'm saying that right. So we have like the neon-y colors, the blue, green, and pink. So this is really, really neat stuff. This will be for a blog giveaway at a to-be-determined date. Let me pull these up real quick on the... on the page over here so we can see what they look like. Kokoyo get down. I like that name. Oh, wrong button. I'm not really efficient at going back and forth on my screens. I need to work on that. I won't pull up all these inks, but I want to see these again. Rozer, thanks for the follow. Appreciate you. This set I did want to pull up. So, it's like a little sampler set. Yeah, finally. Okay, I got there, chat. We got there, chat. Made it. So, yeah, like, I'm not going to open. I'm going to test these out. All right, Gamma, enjoy your lurk. Send me an email. Yeah, I'm going to give these away on the blog coming soon. That's like a cool color setup for me. I really like those. My package of them leaked a tiny little bit. These, let's see, I think I'm good. Wow, they even like shrink wrap the bottle. Has little shrink wrap guys in it. That's crazy. Yeah, it's hard to, ink shipping is what, the worst? Probably. It's tough. But really cool little set. look for that to be a blog giveaway. I don't know, in the coming weeks. I have a lot of giveaways to get to. I have one specifically I've been holding off on. Pannonia Zumo. Is this the one I got for Inkwell Monster? Which was the one that she... No, it was Lichen. Lichen? Did I say it right this time? Lichen? Lichen? Zuzmo. Lichen. Lichen. Ah, is it this one? Lichen? Yeah, this is the one I got for Sarah. Lichen. I can't get that. I don't want it. Lichen, subscribe. Thank you, Molly. Gosh, that's what it was. I still can't get that. I'm sorry, y'all. Lichen. I guess I just don't say it enough. It looks really light on this swab, but when we were seeing the ink colors, it had this really weird kind of cool sheen and stuff on it. So, like and subscribe. I should write that on the bottle when I send it to Sarah. So yeah, we'll see how this goes. So this one, I'm gonna put a label on. Can't really see here. I'm not gonna, Sarah, I'm actually gonna, I'm gonna dip test this on Thursday, if that's cool by you. Like you have a choice. Like you have a choice. But I do need to put your name on this box because I will totally forget. Whoever invented these needs a raise. All right, that one's going to Sarah. By the time I go through all these inks, we'll do another giveaway today. We'll pick out an ink later to give away to y'all on chat, since it's not gonna be this one, and it's not gonna be this one. At the end, I'll figure out which one I wanna give away to y'all. Or maybe I'll let the winner pick or something like that, like which we've done before. Oh. Just don't germs it. Number one, too late. Number two, I know your little rugrat situation too, passing those germs around. So I feel safe that we'll at least cross each other out. You're doomed, yeah. Facts. Am I the thing for expecting an office worker in 2020 to know how to copy and paste a file from one place to the other? No, not the A. All right, then we got these two collas. I don't remember why I ordered these. Are these permanent or are these standard colla inks? Oh, I know what we got this one. That's sweet potato balls, y'all. That's why we got this one. Sweet potato balls. Come on now. You know why we got that one. But these aren't permanent, right? Or are they? Or are all their inks permanent? Pigmented. They're dye-based, thank you. So these are non-pigmented. All right, here's sweet potato ball. They even call it a snack. Snack. Kala Island snack sweet potato balls. I'm in. Sorry, y'all. You want to know why I look so young for being so old? It's because I giggle at sweet potato balls. I mean, how can you not? It's just who I am. It's just who I am. And then the other one we got was Queen She Cliff, which looks cool. This one, not sweet potato balls. it makes me laugh every time. I'm sorry. This one. So I need to, one of the goals today is is, hey, look, too many cameras, too little time. I need to re-ink the Miura pen, and I'm thinking Kingshi Cliff. I'm sorry, I'm butchering that name. That might be a good ink for this pen. Greenish blue. Oh my God, I'm gonna have a stroke. Is your coworker? Just tell him to turn it on and off again. I do like these little bottles. It's a cool shape. I can't help it. It's problematic. Speaking of sweet potato balls, Tony is not here today. He let me know. He's going on vacation. And get some sweet potato balls. All right, so I think this is probably going to be the... can't totally see it there. I think this is going to go in the Mayora. I think this is going to be a cool option for this pen. So that's I'm going to set that aside for right now. Little instruction guy. All right. So that is that from Shigur. Sweet potato ball. Kingshi something cliff. I don't know. That's going to go in here. I'm pretty sure. We're gonna hold that off, and then we're gonna set my balls off to the side, and figure out something to do with that later. All right. Who knows? Maybe you can win it in a giveaway, and therefore I don't have to say it anymore. Next up. That is a fun bottle. That's a cool looking bottle. I always want to call Birmingham pens Birmingham inks, like for the URL. All right, we're gonna do some of these right now. Birmingham Pen Co. Beeham. Sweet potato balls would look nice in a yellow pen. Yeah, it's probably gonna head into like an orange pen or a yellow pen. Like, you know what pen I haven't inked up in a while is my. My Franklin Kristoff Pocket 66, the Pen Addict model we did in orange. And you can eyedropper it. That would be cool. Or maybe, like, it would be cool in this. In the Ultim, but I have, like, a gallon of ink to get through there first. So this is a very specific sticker. All right, see you, Bruce. The best experience open box from this side. So let's do that. Or should we go rogue? Birmingham has so many good inks. That's factually correct. I feel like I should go for the worst experience, but I don't think I would be doing right by Birmingham. Because they always have fun goodies in the top, right? Like, there's usually like a postcard or something, and I'm gonna say all that, and there's gonna be nothing at all this time. Why don't you like them, Mike? Any issues you've run across? Whoops. Is there another sticker on the other side? There wasn't. It was just blank. But yeah, I figured there's like the packing info was on here. Let me know if there's something specific you're running into, Mike. I would be curiouser. I love having a collection of those paper clips. Yeah, they're very neat. Ooh, I got another pen coaster, another ink bottle coaster. Those are always cool. Thank you. Drive through. Yeah, it's cool to have little accessories you can keep. Swift or super bleedy, and the crisp are kind of only okay. Gotcha. I don't think I've tried the Swift yet, and probably won't. I don't know that I need to, but maybe one bottle I'll try. So I've been ordering the crisp, so I think I got mostly crisp on these. Less than impressed. Oh, check it out. Mom packaged this one. You used to love them. You think they've changed? All right. So I've only reviewed Antique Sepia, and I was very happy with it. Another postcard. I'm gonna keep all this. Should keep mom's note. Got a test sheet. All right, let's see what we got here. Let me take all these out. Oh, there was a secret paper at the bottom. Mike, your satisfaction's guaranteed. Have you emailed them to let you know you're less than satisfied? You should do that. Just filled my Twisby swipe with a spring converter. I am not impressed with the fill. No matter how many times I pumped it, it seemed like maximum half full. Well, I mean, just feeling it, the seal doesn't seem awesome. Right? Like, I felt like the sealing on that, the seal around that connection was not great. All right. Let's make some room. I bought them for science. Yeah, that's how most of it goes. Let's see if this works. If not, no big deal. All right, this is the only thing I don't like is I got to go into all these boxes and label them and color tag them. That's what I did with my last ones that I still have sitting here. So I put the color swabs on the top. This is, I'm pretty sure, Pennsylvania slate. Let's see if I'm right. Look at me, Pennsylvania slate. But there's no markings on the exterior box, and I now keep inks in their original boxes. I used to throw away the exterior box, but they're much easier to stack if you keep the boxes. So I would like some form of knowledge on here, but hey, it's also fun that I get to do this too. All right, let's see. You mentioned a proposal you sent to Nick and Josh and nothing. I got no response yet. I do need to follow up on it though, because I'm curious. All right, we got Ohio River here. I guess I don't need to keep them in their particular boxes. Let's just go ahead and unbox all of them real quick. Kyanite. Yeah, their design is cool. Short leaf pine. I think that's the one I really thought was cool. That really neat green. Can't remember if I ordered all crisp inks or did I get something else. Doesn't say exactly. Oh, that's not even theirs. That's the. Yeah, it doesn't say what's what on the label. I think I got. Maybe I got one permanent and a bunch of crisp inks. I'm not sure. Voltaic Arc. No leaks in the packaging, as far as I can tell, which looks good. Hydrangea, that looked cool. That was a really wild looking purple. Kentucky bluegrass. Oh, here's one. If it's not crisp, I guess it has a sticker on it. So this one's everlasting. Let me hold that. So all these, none of these other boxes had stickers on them. So they must be, then I was right. I ordered all crisp inks and then one everlasting, I think is what I did. But we'll have to correct and see. Eroded bronze. I've already given away one bottle of eroded bronze. I'm keeping that one. Gamma Gamma's buddy got the eroded bronze. Voltaic Arc is a rich ink. There's one called Rich. Flamingo Everlasting. Oh, that's right. I got that Flamingo. That's cool. It'll say on the left side of the label. Let's see. Rich formula. Thank you. So what's the difference between rich and crisp? Crisp. What's rich then? Crisp. Okay. And then rich and everlasting. All right. What is rich? Sheening. Rich is sheening. Okay, that's why I only got one of those, because I'm not a huge sheen guy. But I thought it looked interesting enough to see. We're, like I said, we're just unboxing these today. We're going to test them all out on Thursday. Oh, yeah, this is like the blue and red sheen. That could be cool. Like, you can see a little bit on the edge of the ink bottle there. That could be cool. Yeah, I look forward to that. So we're going to do all the testing of these on Thursday. Flamingo. That is a really weird... it's like neon Mylanta. But this one, like Mike says, we bought this one for an experiment. I don't know whether I'm going to like it, if it's going to be good or bad. But it at least looked interesting and fun to experiment with. I feel like I need to shake it constantly. And shortleaf pine. This one I was curious about. Yeah, this one looks cool. It's like a grayish green here. Hang on, I'm about to pull this up. I need my Stream Deck on the other side of the desk where I can actually reach it and switch these scenes without having to pull out my keyboard. So yeah, this shortleaf pine was one I wanted to look at. It's pretty cool. Hydrangea, all these inks look like they're gonna be pretty cool. So looks like a melted flamingo in a bottle. Nice, I'm gonna use that if I review it. Ooh, that could go good in the vac, although I wouldn't want to stain the vac. I don't know how these everlasting inks do in there. Maybe hydrangea goes in the vac. All right, let's look up hydrangea. That's right, we need to pick an ink for the vac. Yeah. Hi, it's me. I keep hitting the wrong buttons. That could be a good vac. That could be a good iris ink. Good morning, killer sheep. That could be good for this one. Maybe. So, yeah. All right. We'll think about these. So, yeah. We're going to do testing on all of these on Thursday. So, you want to stay tuned for that. We have a lot of testing to do, apparently. All right. I shouldn't bother unboxing these, but if I don't, I'll have double the mess instead of single the mess. Hey, Llama Pajamas. I was tempted to get Sailor 123 for my iris, but it's so expensive. Yeah, for a small bottle, it's very expensive. I think I have a sample that someone sent me that I don't use. If you want to try a sample of it, I think I still have it. I'll have to look. If I find it, I'll send it to you. I don't know if I still have it, though. I don't want to commit to it if I'm not sure. I have hydrangea in my Wicked Witch of the West Sailor. And you like it? Put a sample of the 123 in my Namisu. Works well with the titanium. Oh, that's a good match. I like that. That's a cool setup. All right, we got one more box to get through. And then we'll do another giveaway. We'll give away an ink. I don't know which one yet. Because there's some I definitely don't want to give away that I want to be for sure to test. So I don't know if I'll do it like completely randomly or like I'll pick out something that I'm good on passing right in the beginning. We'll see. Because I like to have y'all's input in it, but I also like there's some things I do need to keep for testing purposes. Smand. All right. Big box here. I can't remember if I ordered just inks and this is how they got packaged. So let's see. Let's just fill up the desk here. See what's about to happen. Happy Face Mike. Mike Van Ness, not, I mean, Independence Mike always has Happy Face on. But that was on my receipt. Is that it? Is that everything? Large box. Oh yeah, I think it looks like I ordered some paper stuff along with the inks. Ooh, we got the Van Diemen's in this box. Nice. Hello. I do have an ink question. I have a little sample of a lovely purple ink which seems to have lost some of its moisture and isn't flowing very well in the pen I inked it up with. Is it okay to add a couple of drops in the water for a better flow, or is that a no-no? It's a yes, yes. You can do that. A couple. Like, don't go nuts, but like, literally a couple of drops. I wouldn't hesitate to do it. Anyone disagree with that? Maybe some people disagree with that. I don't know. I'm fine adding like a couple of drops of water to like an ink sample vial. Like 2 drops. I would use distilled water. Makes sense. Sorry for the ASMR vibes. Except with OS inks where you might need a lot of water to make it manageable. Yeah, like if it's a really tricky ink, like a Organic Studio Nitrogen, I would be more nervous about that just because I'm nervous about that ink to begin with. People say you're supposed to use distilled water, but I wouldn't worry about it for a sample. Makes sense. Megas. All right. Oh, we got, man, that's a, how much ink is in this bottle? I can't tell y'all how heavy this ink bottle is. 60 milliliter bottle. This is like crazy heavy. All right, let's see what we got here. Ooh, okay. Holy crap. I can't even fit this under the camera. This is a Ferris wheel press sketchbook. Lay flat blank pages, 240 pages, 160 GSM paper, accordion pocket. Look how big this is. Like, I have a big head. Holy cow. How much was this? What the hell was I thinking? This looks like a Sarah product. $40. That seems like at least a $40 product. Holy cow. I gotta put this on the regular camera. Like, we're talking like textbook level product here. It's $40. Like, that seems like good. So for comparison, here's what we would call a traditional A5, like 192 page standard edition notebook. Right, this is your basic, this is your stock A5 diary journal notebook versus whatever Ferris wheel press has done here, and it's kind of impressive. I had no idea. I was like, $40, that's probably pretty cool. Like, I'm not surprised it's not $80. I think they had some different color cover patterns. This is the Ferris wheel press, the sketchbook. It's not the Ferris wheel press sketchbook. It's the sketchbook by Ferris wheel press. I'll show you on here. The sketchbook. The sketchbook. I remember there's like 3 other color, like cover patterns, like a green and maybe a purple. I can't remember. Or a blue. Carnet de croquis. Very good, very good. It's the sketchbook. The sketchbook. I mean, You make a sketchbook this big, I guess you can call it the sketchbook. $40 for big notebook, yes. It's really nice. I want to open it up, but I don't because I want to send it to someone to review. I'm not going to review it. Like, I could not review this product, like, in any way, shape, or form. It's kind of impressive, though. Somebody bring me medicine at work, please. Okay, thanks. I mean, we're already having to go reload on medicine here. So, no, it's sketchbook, so it's blank. A blank canvas made for creatives, illustrators, artists, and dreamers. It's almost like a Fig Baron thing. Imbue your most wondrous ideas on 240 pages of high-quality 160 GSM pH-neutral acid-free paper. The sketchbook features an accordion pocket to keep all your inspirations at hand, and you'll always find your way with a plump 7/8 of an inch grow grain ribbon place marker. Plump markering right there, chat. Plump markering. Yeah, like, I do not fit this description. Therefore, I should not use this notebook. Woo. Yeah, Sarah is my Huckleberry for this one. That's facts. That's definitely going to Sarah. There's no way I would do a good job at reviewing this. I would just say, man, this is cool and it's awesome. But, like, that's all I got. Look at this thing. Holy cow. I'm sorry. This is not what I expected in a very positive way. Crazy. All right. Let me stop fawning over that thing. I hope it's good. That's the best I can say right now is I hope it's good because it is certainly girthy. Any update on when the bronze and green icons are dropping? We're still weeks away. We did pencils last week. Yeah, it's still a few weeks away. It's not very long, but there's just so much prep work that goes into that that it just takes time. So, not long. It's something I'd never use because I'd be nervous to. Yeah, you got to be committed to this. And, like, Sarah, I feel, not to put any pressure on her, like, she would be... Like, there's a review part of it, and then there's a use part of it. And even though it's, like, sketchbook paper, not necessarily, like, writing paper, I have a feeling that she could fill this up. All right, we got a Faber-Castell. This notebook feels so puny compared. This is, like, a big notebook, and it just feels so insignificant compared to whatever Ferris Wheel Press did here. So this is a normal notebook, A5 Faber-Castell. This is just something, again, a new thing to test. You should write an illuminated manuscript in that piece. Illuminated? Yeah, you should. Yeah, so this is just something I haven't tried that I think is worth testing out. I like what Faber-Castell does, obviously. There is a review on the blog today, penaddict.com. I mean, a giveaway of a pen. And this is just something that I would normally send to Sarah, but I'm going to send her this one instead. So Kimberly or Jeff will probably get this one to test out. And we just need to see if it's any good, right? To see, hey, does this make the recommendation list for some reason? So I'm surprised by the price. Ferris Wheel makes some beautiful things, but I generally find them a bit overpriced for what they are. $40 sounds like a fair price for a book that big. I agree with the entire sentiment. All right, so there you go, there's that. And then I got some letter writing stuff for somebody. I buy letter writing stuff just to send it to other people to do something with, because, you know, I'm not gonna write any letters. But this was like a matchy matchy set from, is this Midori? Yeah, Midori made some new matchy matchy sets of envelopes and papers. Sorry for the noise. Apparently this is the hot color this year. It's this yellowy orange, which I'm here for. All right, so letter writing kit, right? So you can, you have these bright yellow pages. You have to use a very interesting ink. So it's they call it three. I don't know if the official name is three, but three tones. 24 sheets, so 8 sheets of 3 colors, right? And then they have like the yellow tone. They have a set of blue tones. And then I think there's at least one or two other color sets. You'll have to go look. But I thought this was a neat setup because people always want letter sets, right? So this one, when you open the envelopes, like the envelope backing, like the inner inside liner matches the yellow color. And so then you can have the three different colors pages to use. I don't know how, well, the main question here is like on a paper this dense of color, this saturated of color, is how a water-based ink is going to work on this. Like I'd be very curious to test out. So Brad, write letters. I didn't say I would write letters. I said I'd probably send this to someone who does. Although this one, that's cool. This is a cool little notepad. Retro Apprentice, thank you so much. Played some alternate images. Thank you. That is a great song. So this is like a little note set that could be go along with your letters. I just thought it was a really neat setup. They have multiple colors of this. Several colors, actually. I know he's written half a letter. It's still up there, I'm pretty sure. Sending it to someone is basically sending a letter. That's how I do it at Talon A. Like, I'll just send someone all of these, and here you say, you're welcome. That's how I do it. I should really download Slack. Slack is full. Just kidding. Reject letter sets, embrace letter locking. Look at you, Evan, the letter locking master. Right here for everybody. Brick Lane, thanks for the follow. Appreciate you. Appreciate you hanging out. Eric with the letter locking. I love you for that. All right. So, wow. That was some, you know, poor Faber-Castell. I feel like you got left in the dust on what would normally be like, hey, cool new notebook day. I was like, what just happened here with this Ferris wheel press stuff? So, interesting. Interesting stuff. All right. Shmevelin with the gifted sub. Thank you, Shmevelin. You are too kind. I do hope you're feeling better soon. Send someone a pen, ink, and a notebook and call it a DIY letter. That's actually like a product idea. Write your own letter kit. Like it's so like so dumb, it would actually work. Brad sends letters with the goods, all fewer than a dozen words on an index card. Do you know how much I hate writing those lists, Sarah? Every time I do it, I'm going, I should do a better job and have this like in an official capacity, like send you like, I should like inventory the stuff when it comes in, tag who it came from, tag who I'm sending it to. Like, and I've set up this whole Kanban board to do it. And then I don't do it. And then I have to pull all the stuff to ship to you. And then I'm like, son of a gun, I have to remember what all this is. I'm just going to put it on this stupid note card and throw it in the box. And then hopefully when you ask me a question when I've made a mistake, I try to remember it. Welcome to my world, chat. That is literally how my life goes every day. See ya, Tommy. All right. Let me get this out of the way here. That is the story of my life. So essentially, I rage write those notes because I feel like a failure is the short version of that. Let's open up this private reserve because I'm concerned at how heavy this this box is. It is sizable. My only issue is I write so many letters, I don't know what to write about, so I write about weird stuff. My last letter was about carrots and radar. I think that's, like, perfect. I write 20, 25 letters a month, and I have two kids. Well, you're just showing off now, Tessa. Tessa is banned for 5 minutes, please, mods. I need an item for $6.50 from JetPens. Have you tried that, what's that paper where there's three different versions of the paper? Is it the Kikuyo? Like, where they spelled paper backwards? Perpinep, yes, thank you. Paper pen. That's what you need. So pick out one of the Perpineps notebooks. I think they're like $10. And they have different paper textures. We haven't tested those out yet. I wouldn't recommend it timing out a mod unless you did one mod. I was just joking. I was just joking. All right. This is like a moisturizer bottle, right? This is, all right, ready? This is danger. Danger, y'all ready? These are sizable bottles. 60 milliliters of ink in a very large, like, I feel like just going like this and this. Okay. It's a bottle. It's a bottle. Infinity turquoise. So this is new recipe, theoretically, private reserve, and we're going to test it out. I don't know, but they charge for it. Like, these are not the old pricing of private reserve. I think this is at least a $25 bottle of ink, which is fine. Like, that's fairly priced. Is it like half full? It's more than half full. It's taped around here. I'm not going to open it up today. We'll do that Thursday. It does make it stay, like, I'm totally good with the stability. You're going to run out of depth pretty quick, right? If there's no alternate, like, side angle, like, build. Like, I would rather have, I don't know, something else, like a standard or more traditional bottle, because you're going to hit the bottom of this, like, really quick. So, we'll see how it goes Thursday. But, I don't know, I was shocked at how heavy this box was. Interesting. Well, I mean, the box itself is not bigger than, like, the Sailor Gentle ink boxes. They're about that size. So, we've just gotten used to these smaller size bottles, down from the 50. Mine did. It was full. This one doesn't look full, so we'll see how it goes. All right, then we got the Van Diemen's. Where's Pepper Berry? So this is Pepper Berry. This is the one I wanted to try for myself again. It's like a dark blue. These are the more standard small little platinum bottles is what I remember these being in first. Platinum ink bottles are shaped like this in some of their smaller, like, basic inks back in the day. Yeah, these are great bottles. Small, compact. So this is a blue-black ink on the darker side of the ledger. It almost looks like it has a little bit of a purpley tint, but we'll see. Again, we're going to test all of these out on Thursday. Doesn't Kiwi use those? I have no idea. I don't have any Kiwi inks. I should get some Kiwi inks. I think I'm covered for a while, though. What did I get here? Pixie Parasols. Like, how can you not order Pixie Parasols? So it's like a light, bright blue. Looks like a cool color. I like that color in my Sailor Mount Fuji, right? I bought that Fujiyama blue. It's that light color that actually works for me on a blue. I have a weird thing about large bottles that are half full. I don't want the half full part because it makes sense, but why so big in the first place? Facts. So that was that. Ooh, I know what I'm giving away today. Needle Girl, so sad my boss has decided we're having a weekly department meeting at 10 a.m. on Thursdays. Give me his email or her email. Give me their email and we'll have a talk. Unacceptable. What is this? Wilderness Series, Devil's Kitchen. What's up? It's your boy. Finally remembered to catch the AM stream. Well, it's like 6 a.m. for you right now, I'm pretty sure. Wow, that is filled very, very high. Is that like a bubble or is that like way higher than the rest of these? No, it's just way higher than the rest of these. So this looks like a interesting blue, interesting thing. So yeah, we'll test these out. I figured out what I'm giving away, chat. All right, that's the unboxing. I was going to give away an ink, but like I'm hesitant because like I need to decide which ones I want to test, which ones I'm going to ship to the review crew, what's good. Oh, we didn't open this one. Meg, yes. Let's see what this one is. See, I would rather have this bottle than the private reserve bottle. At least give me some depth in there. So this was the red that y'all were recommending when I was shopping for them. So yeah, this was the color that everyone said that they really liked for a red. So instead of me having to decide, I actually brought something in here. Man, look at that. That is crazy. I brought something in here the other day that I needed to give away that I think you're gonna like. As a matter of fact, I know you're gonna like it. It's not a stationery item per se, but it's stationery related. First time on Twitch, great unboxing. Hey, thank you, Barrelentine. We do this pretty frequently, at least once a month. We'll have some kind of huge unboxing day. And then what we're gonna do is we have like, I don't know, a dozen inks to test. So come Thursday, I'll have a big pad right here and we're just gonna start slapping inks on everything to see what they look like, how they behave, what the colors are like, all that fun stuff. So I'm glad you joined us. I really appreciate that. So yeah, I brought something in here the other day. Said this would be the perfect giveaway item. So that way I don't have to choose one of these products today because I don't know yet. I don't want to make a wrong decision. So let me show you what we're going to give away. And then I'll maybe ink up this Mayora that I need to. Alan Chaos, you go with the gifted sub to Barrelentine. Thank you, Alan. That is awesome. You are an awesome human being. You also have a half letter written right there. All right, so I had this on my desk in the other room because my good friends sent me this because they're cool that way and they want me to pimp their products, and that's just what I do. Like, I can be bought. I think let's give away my Paradise pin set that my friends at Esterbrook sent me. What do you think? I think we should give this to y'all because this is like legit cool. Like, this is one of those things that it's like, oh man, it's so perfect. I want to keep it. It's for me. But then I'll like never like use it. So I think I should give it to y'all. Like, and these are like the real, these are like the metal pens, you know, with the posts and the things. Like, it's, that's a cool set of pens with a knot case to pin them to. I need to bring some knot cases in here to give away. I have knot cases and spoke pins or stuff I need to give away. I just don't have them right now. All right, let me scooch this. I need to get back to my keyboard. I blocked myself out. All right, all right, all right, all right. Too much stuff. Too much stuff. All right. Let's give this away. Ooh, this one is very penny. It's like poking out the bottom. All right, so what do we have here? We have the Paradise JRs. We have the Esterbrook logo. We have, we'll go with Pina Colada. We have a parrot on a pin. And then we have sunglasses. They also sent me a t-shirt that I gave to my wife. If you're listening, Carrie, you need to check the sizes on your t-shirts. Oof. All right, the parrot is on a pin. PPP. For new people, how do giveaways work? Exclamation point giveaway. Is that how I did it? But basically what we're gonna do here in Uno Momento, I'm gonna launch a giveaway. All you have to do is type exclamation point raffle and you are entered. You only have to do it once. Even if you do it 50 times, it's not going to improve your chances because it just overwrites your entry every single time. Esterbrook pin set. So right now, what I'm gonna do is hit open giveaway on my side. You're gonna get a little alert on your side. And then you type exclamation point raffle and you're automatically entered. Thank you, Kate. So then I run this for 2 minutes. I keep this running for 2 minutes. During that time, I am going to ink up this Mayora with the, I really cannot pronounce this, y'all. King Shui. Qingshui Cliff. I really apologize if I'm butchering that. in my Mayora. I forget the color of this. So let's do this real quick. Steph is over here sweet talking the bot. I can't deny what Steph's doing because she won a giveaway like 2 weeks ago. So, you know, happens. All right. I think I left the converter in here. I can't. Can y'all do this? Like, are you happy? Are you content doing filling the pen with the blind caps? I'm not. Like, I get it. Like, it's a cool feature, but like, I'm always just going in. What are we raffling for? This pen set. This Esterbrook pen set that they Kenro Industries, courtesy of Kenro Industries. So I have to go inside the pen, instead of using the blind cap thing, right? So. So we'll fill that up. We don't need to go super deep. I was prepared. I brought a paper towel in there earlier today because I knew I'd at least be filling one pin up. So let's do this. Y'all have like 5 seconds left to get on the raffle. Not captured at all. 0% blind cap. Okay, so it's like, it's a captured whatever. I mean, it's just a blind cap. I don't know what the question is. It's non-useful. Besides, I think it's cool looking, but it's like, from a functionality perspective, it's a whatever for me. All right, the giveaway is over. I will pick a winner in a minute. Mayor and Leonardo should start a fake feud. That would be funny. All right. This on here, it's way too small to turn that many rotations. Yeah, it's like, why bother? But I mean, I get it. It's a cool thing. Who knows? All right. Oh yeah, this color is gonna be good in that pen, right? Look at that green and blue kind of fadey stuff. All right. The winner is. The great goddess of giveaways, Schmevelin. Congrats, Schmevelin. See, you should be sick on chat more often. Doesn't offer any extra value to the pen? Yeah, I'm with you. It's like I go, okay. It's here, like when I talk about the blind cap, it's like, okay, this is here, but it's like, I don't need it or use it. All right, which color haven't we used? I don't think we've used the blue one yet. Schmevelin. All right. Sorry, Penguin. Oh. Ferns Taws, thank you for the follow. I apologize, my alert did not pop up. But thank you so much, I appreciate you. All right, Schmevelin, please email your shipping address. Look at Gamma Gamma. Like he knows the rules now. Big winner, Gamma Gamma wins one time and he's all of a sudden the rule bot. I have no idea if I smelled Schmevelin right because I didn't look. Wins once becomes expert. You're not really going to be able to see this color on this little tiny thing that I wrote here, but this color is going to be really good. Oh man, you can't see this at all. We'll do it Thursday. This color is going to be perfect for this pen. That was the goal, and I think we did it. All right, chat, this was a day. That was a pretty easy 2 hours, I'm not going to lie. Like, we could go another 2 hours if we were going to do all this inking today, but I actually have shipping to do. I wish all of my streams were this long. Sometimes it's just not possible with my schedule sometimes. Some days, like today, it just really opens up until the afternoon. And I can keep going. So let's see who we're going to raid today. It's Novin. Thank you for the Twitch Prime sub. That is really, really awesome. I really appreciate you so much for picking me to use your Prime sub with. That's awesome. All right, so let's see. Who do we have? Just real quick. All my follows are playing games, which is cool. Oh, no, Simarchy's in Makers and Crafting. Sushi Zuni's in Genshin Impact. Independence Mike is playing Northgard. Who can we raid today? Any suggestions? Any suggestions? Thank you, Molly, for showing up. I really appreciate you. Let's see. PMS Proxy is making wallets. Who can we go say hi to? Should we go say hi to Mike today? We haven't raided Mike in a while. It's been a few weeks. Any other suggestions? What is Northgard? Oh, that looks cool. Let's go raid Mike. Yeah, that looks cool. This game looks cool. Whatever Mike's playing, I'm going to watch this. So I'm going to raid this for me. Y'all guys say hi to Mike. Y'all are allowed to spam him. I generally say, especially our friends who are like studying, like Bryant, sometimes we don't want to interrupt him with too much raid action, but we can go antagonize Mike. So, let me get him going here. Of course it doesn't come up in the list. Why would it? I mean, he's only in my follow list. We're going to go check out this game. All right. Thanks for hanging out today. I'll be back tomorrow after podcast. Podcast 10 a.m. tomorrow. Stream 11:30-ish. And then Thursday, we're going to take all this stuff that I have on the desk right now, and we're going to test it all out. So go say hi to Mike. Go be a Viking. Enjoy. Doing. How you feeling?